If you have seen docks and ports in person like me, you will be deeply shocked by the huge cargo ships, giant cranes, trucks shuttling back and forth, and containers neatly stacked like building blocks. Have you ever wondered how these huge container ports work? How are containers unloaded? Where do they go after they are unloaded? Are the seemingly neat docks really as orderly as they appear? And what changes has the addition of automation technology brought to this traditional industry? About 80% of the world's trade is completed by sea transportation, and container ports are the core nodes of this huge logistics system. In the early years, cargo ships would mix various goods together, which had low loading and unloading efficiency, high error rate, and even easy damage. Now, almost all goods are loaded into containers of uniform specifications, which greatly improves loading and unloading efficiency. But this also brings new challenges, because now a giant ship has to unload hundreds or even thousands of containers at will, and only large docks with strong loading and unloading capabilities can do it. The port is not only a place for unloading, but also a hub for global intermodal transport. Here, goods are converted from sea to land, rail, and even air transport. Although air transport is expensive and is still not the mainstream mode of transport for containers, the existence of ports is to achieve efficient and seamless conversion. When a cargo ship docks, the first step is to unload the container with a huge gantry crane. Some of these cranes are movable, while others are installed on tracks and can lift containers weighing dozens of tons at a time. The corner parts, dimensions, and identification codes of containers are all formulated by the International Organization for Standardization, ISO, to ensure the uniformity and interoperability of global transportation. Such standardization also brings convenience to automation. In some advanced ports, such as the Port of Rotterdam in the Netherlands, the cranes have been remotely controlled, and the operator can complete loading and unloading by sitting in front of a computer. The unloaded containers will first be transported to the port yard. Here, the containers will wait to be picked up by trucks or trains and transported to cities, factories, or other ports. You may not know that most terminal trucks are only responsible for short-distance transportation within the port and are responsible for delivering containers from the dock to the yard. That's all. In the port, there are two types of machinery that are particularly eye-catching. One is called rubber tire gantry crane, which can completely span several rows of containers and even run on tracks. The other is telescopic forklift, which can flexibly stack containers and accurately position them. All of these devices may be fully automatic or controlled by human-machine collaboration. In smart ports, the scheduling system will arrange them to operate efficiently to avoid disordered stacking of containers. Automation is already changing the face of ports around the world. In the Port of Rotterdam, after the containers are unloaded from the ship, they will be transported to the yard by self-driving trucks, and the automatic cranes will stack them according to the algorithm for efficient extraction in the future. The storage, movement, and extraction of each container are all planned by the system in order to reduce the handling steps and save time. However, not all ports have advanced systems. Some places still use paper documents for management. Containers can only be stacked on a first-come, first-served basis. When it is time to retrieve, it is discovered that it is buried at the bottom, which means that the boxes on top must be moved first, which is extremely inefficient. This is the importance of automated ports. This is Qingdao Port. Just a few years ago, all this still required a large number of workers and manual operations. However, today, everything has changed. Now it is like a giant robot city, and all operations are highly automated. Unmanned guided vehicles, AGVs, are like couriers shuttling through the streets, accurately delivering containers from the ship to the yard. Key cranes are like huge mechanical arms, quickly and safely unloading containers. And all this takes only a few minutes. The intelligent dispatching system of this terminal is like a brain, responsible for directing the work of AGVs, automated yard cranes, and other equipment to ensure that every container can reach its destination smoothly and in time. Here, all operations are supported by big data and 5G technology without any human intervention. Automation brings efficiency, safety, and precision, but it also raises concerns about unemployment. Some experts suggest that in order to make up for the loss of tax revenue, a robot tax should be levied. The relationship between humans and machines is not antagonistic. In many scenarios, they can work together. Humans handle emergencies, and machines are responsible for repetitive, inefficient tasks. Container ports are super hubs for modern logistics. Every lifting and every transportation carries the pulse of the world economy. If you like this kind of popular science content, don't forget to like, follow, and share. See you in the next video.